All right, so how many people here have ever wondered, what's the point? What's my purpose? Why am I here in this life? Anybody? Mm-hmm. Yeah? Everybody? Every single one of us has a purpose. You do. And every single one of us was perfectly matched to our purpose. We have exactly the skills and talents and abilities that we need to do what we were born to do, what we were created to do. And when we find our purpose and we live it, we will have what I call real, authentic success. Real success is 5 points. So Hollywood would like to tell us that it's fame, and Wall Street would like to tell us that it's money. No, it's not. Real success is having really good relationships with healthy people. It's having good health, so you're not stressed out all the time. It's having peace. I didn't even know what peace was until I was over 40. I lived the first 40 years of my life in chaos, most of which I created. I didn't even know. Number 4 is joy. Real joy is sustainable. It's not just happiness. So I can be happy. I'm driving along. I'm singing the happy song. And then somebody cuts me off in traffic, and I'm not happy anymore. Joy is inside, and it stays with you. It's sustainable. It doesn't matter if you get cut off in traffic. It doesn't matter if you lose your job. It doesn't matter what happens. You have joy inside of you. And then the 5th thing is financial provision. Turns out, the Edison always still wants to get paid, right? We need money in this life. But we don't need to have a zillion dollars. How much is enough? I personally know people who are billionaires with a B who aren't happy. So what we need is enough financial provision, number 5, in order to do what we were created to do. That's really authentic, sustainable success. And when we have it, we don't have to compete with anybody. We don't have to strive. We don't have to try to be better. We don't have to worry about, you know, our new neighbor, they got a new car, my car's falling apart. You don't compare yourself when you're living your purpose. So I want to give you 5 quick things, because that's our format today. Almost like a TED Talk thing. We're going to hit you with quick individual talks that are our signature talks. We have, all of us, an awful lot to say. We could stay here for a week and a half, but we're not going to do that. So I'm going to give you 5 ways that you know your purpose. Does anybody here already know your purpose? No? Don't all reach out at once. So if you want to know your purpose, here's how to do it. The very first thing is list your strengths. Find your strengths. If you take an assessment, you take strengths finders or one of those, but know what your strengths are. That's the way you're hardwired. That's who you are. And you know, some people won't like it. I happen to be extremely tenacious. Some people would say it's nagging. So, you know, the strengths that you have might actually be the things that people have criticized you for. Hey, you know what? If you're tenacious, if you persevere, if you're courageous, if you do what needs to be done, if you shift from passive fear to active coping, then I want you to own it. I want you to be that person, because that's the way you were made. So, number 1, strengths. Number 2, your natural talents. Everybody has different natural talents. Some people are amazing listeners. Is there anybody in the room who, like, people will even in the grocery line just start telling you their life story. Looking right at one of my friends. You're a good listener, and you just sort of automatically, magnetically attract people who want to tell you everything that's ever happened to them in their life. That's a natural gift. That's a talent that you have. Some people are just excellent at nurturing others and taking care of others and seeing what needs to be done before anybody else sees what needs to be done, and then doing it before anybody even noticed that it needed done. Some people are excellent at communication, naturally. Some people are talented at leadership. They'll just take charge of any given situation. It's a natural talent. Number three, your learned abilities. This is what you learn in school, in life. What were you taught to do? What did you pick up along the way that somebody took you under their wing and taught you? It doesn't have to be a master's degree in social work like Connie has. It doesn't have to be a PhD. It can be that somebody took you under their wings and taught you how to balance a checkbook. Whatever it is, your learned abilities are clues to your purpose. Because you learned it along the way. There's a reason for it. I'm going to look in my pocket for number four. All right. Oh, no wonder I forgot.
Memory,
yeah. Number four is what grieves your heart. Child abuse really bothers me. I mean, child abuse and child trafficking lights my hair on fire. Animal abuse, elder abuse, whatever it is, whatever's going on in the world that you can't tolerate. It might be deceit. It might be people who walk around telling lies and betraying other people. Whatever grieves your heart, maybe you were called to do something about. And whatever you really enjoy doing, this is the flip side of that. So I'm still on number four. If you do something where when you're doing it, you lose track of time, you forget to eat. I mean, I can sit down and have an idea for a book, and I start writing at 5 a.m., and by 2 o'clock in the afternoon, I realize, oh, I'm still in my pajamas. I forgot to eat. I go to get up, I'm stiff, I can't move. I get lost in it. So if there's something that you love doing and you feel most alive when you do it, guess what? You're probably supposed to do that. That's a big clue. All right, now I'm going to give you the secret sauce, number five. The secret sauce is mining the lessons, I call them the assets, out of what we've been through. The most painful events in our lives. Some people want to push it down, don't talk about it, don't bring it up, it hurts too much, I can't deal with it. I get it. I didn't tell anybody that my parents left me and I was abused by caregivers when I was a kid. I didn't tell anybody that till I was 27 years old. So I totally get the coping skill of denial. It actually is the most effective coping skill there is when you just deny it. But the secret sauce of our purpose comes from really openly looking at it, pulling it out, and saying, I'm going to really look as objectively as I can about what happened to me. Who did what to me? What choices I made? The whole thing. Think of it like you're a journalist, you're a reporter, and you're gathering data. Try to think of it as though it was somebody else. and say, how did it change me? Of course it changed you. You're human. But let me tell you, the painful things that happen in our lives, what happens is they tenderize our hearts. We become much more sensitive to the pain of others. We become much more empathetic. And actually what happens too, when we really start peeling the onion and we really start looking at what's happened to us, we find that we know how to do things and we know how to survive things that the average person doesn't. And that uniquely qualifies us to help other people who are still suffering what we've suffered in the past. So for example, with me, my mother left me with a babysitter and said she was going shopping and then she never came back. She never came back. And I emancipated from foster care when I was 16. But there were many, 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 many days when I waited by the front door, it had a big window, and I would just wait because I thought she might come back. That's abandonment. But what abandonment taught me was that nobody was going to rescue me. I have never, ever bought a lottery ticket thinking that I was going to win the big money. I never expected to marry a wealthy man. I never expected the government to bail me out. I was self-reliant. So guess what? When I was 27 years old, I sold everything and I started my own company. What the heck? Been alone my whole life. I never expected the insurance fairies to come in the middle of the night and do my paperwork. I've always known if anything was going to happen that I wanted to have happen, I was going to have to do the work to make it happen. Being poor when I was a kid and going days and days and days without eating, being homeless when I was 8 years old, eating half-eaten food out of the trash can, when I started to make money, boy, did I manage that money. When you're poor, you have to manage money. Learning money, financial management, although I did go and get a degree in financial management, financial planning, that's not where I learned it. I learned it when I was 8. The abuse that I experienced developed in me a burning desire for justice. If I'm in a grocery store and I hear a baby crying, my radar goes, tired? Hungry? Abused? Oh, I will make a call. See, that's what happens. Whatever painful experiences you've been through, build something in you. So you take your strengths, your talents, what you've learned how to do, what you love doing, what grieves your heart, and what lessons, character traits, coping skills that come out of what you've been through, and you add all of that together. And then you figure out how to use it to help others. Because the whole point of this life is for us to help others, connect with others, love others, do what I call our no big deal. If every one of us did that, we'll be fulfilling our purpose. So when you use all of those assets together, yours is unique. Yours is unique. We may have a lot in common, but yours is unique. Every one of us has this unique set of assets. When you put that to use, helping others, doors will open, opportunities will come your way, people who need what you know how to do will be attracted to you, and you're going to wake up one day and you're going, oh, I'm living my purpose. This is it. I'm doing it. And that's when you begin to get your real success. That's it.